deconstruct this. I have not soldered the cap on. I did that on purpose.
As you can see the piston down in there, I still have to drill. I have to drill the hole for the port. First, I'm going to drill it in this half. Take this. I found a spring in my spring box that will probably work. There we go. You
can see that little inlet that I cut in the flywheel. There's the piston. There we go. I unscrewed it. It's stuck in here. Anyway, I've got to drill a hole all the way through fairly near the top. Maybe an eighth of an inch down from the top. And then I'm going to hook this back up with the piston, flywheel, everything, and move it to its extremes. Move the flywheel with the connecting rod and piston connected. Move it to the 3 o'clock and the 9 o'clock. So that'll be 3 o'clock and 9 o'clock. And then when they're at those extremities, mark through that hole in here. Mark where I'm gonna drill the port, intake and exhaust ports. I haven't decided what size those are going to be. Probably, I might start with 1/16 and then make them a little bigger from there. The picture shows two different sizes. Maybe like the intake is a little larger than the exhaust. Don't know. Remember earlier, I trued in this vise so that it's exactly parallel to the table. So I can rely, and I haven't moved it since, so I can rely on that to be straight. So I want this hole, the new hole, the intake port hole in the cylinder, to be in line with the pivot point. So I'm using an index drill. An index drill is simply drill bits, basically drill bits that don't have any flutes. They don't cut. They're strictly for measuring, gauging. You can gauge hole sizes, and they're straight and everything. So I can recommend, if you're going to do work, to get you a set of these. Once I know I'm right dead over that hole, and I just fiddle with the hand wheels back and forth until I'm dead on, right about there. Now I can take this out and put a center drill in there. Use the hand wheels to count over. I've already marked off an eighth of an inch. I'm going to use my eighth inch line. But you can use the hand wheels to just count up over. I'm going to put a center drill in there, the smallest one I have that's even slightly sharp. So I'm bringing the table up. Oops. So you can see I'm lined up right on the previous hole. I'm lined up right with the hole. I just have to hit the 1/8 inch mark is all I have to do. So I just spot it real quick and see if I'm on the line. A little bit over.
Right. I don't know what the diameter of that center drill is, so I'm not going to go any deeper than that. So I've got a 16th inch drill bit. All right, there's my port. I'll put this on the frame plate, slide it to its extremes, and mark it.
now evening up the cylinder faceplate as smooth and as true as I can get it, so that it mates with the frame faceplate, the exhaust and intake. These have to mate up very closely because that's the valve, right? I was looking for some 320 to start this out, but I have 400 wet or dry, and I've got some oil on here. And this is, I got it on the surface plate, so it's perfectly flat. Flat piece of sandpaper, wet or dry. Of course, the important part is that it mates. I don't know if you can pick up on that little burr. That's the 16th inch intake port in the cylinder. Just want to get rid of that burr. And the thing is, the piston is going to come up just below that hole. It can actually, you know, it could come up to halfway cover it. That's where the steam comes in to push the piston down, right there in that hole. You can see it. To drill a hole in the base plate for the ports, for the pivot pin. With the pivot pin in place, I'm going to take this handy dandy Sears scratch awl, or whatever you want to call it. Go through that 16th inch hole and make a mark that I can use. Drill the exact location of the ports. Okay, I'm doing this again because the, of course, drilling the hole lifted up some of the metal around the circumference of the hole, so I have to smooth that down. Sandpaper is about worn out. That looks pretty good. I don't want to get this too high up here because then it would interfere with it would hit the top. The cap sticks down, 16th or 3/32nds. But I think I've got clearance, no problem. Alright, I have the cylinder plate mated to the port plate, exhaust and intake port plate, and I went ahead and put the spring on there. And it looks like a pretty good fit. You can see the port poke its little head out there. So what I need to do is mark this faceplate with the location of the portholes. So I'm going to use this scribe. First I'm just going to get the arc by going back and forth. And then I'll come in, I'm going to put the flywheel on, go to the extremes, make this scribe line too deep because then it's going to be a channel where the air will escape. Flywheel. That is resting at the 9 o'clock position. So that is far over as the crankshaft will take the piston. So I need to mark that. Let's see, that should have made a mark. That's gonna leave a mark. Oh yeah, I can see that. All right, that's one. Now I'm gonna do the 3 o'clock. Alright, let's see what we got. Does that show up on camera? You can see the arc. And there's my two little marks. And I'm going to drill 16th inch holes in there. Now I've got to do the punch mark thing on these. I'm just gonna let this little tiny punch, it's just gonna find those holes. Might even make a like a click. You hear that? Gotta make a pretty good dent because I don't have a center drill handy. I don't have one that is tiny. I really should use a tiny center drill. Drill bit should be able to pick those up.
There, you can see him now. It's like kind of a little dude or something, a little face. Oh no, Mr. Bill! Oh, Mr. Bill! Okay, we're over here at the mill. My little buddy here. Mr. Bill! Sorry, little buddy. This won't hurt a bit. And you'll be a better person for it. And make your eyes bigger. Alright, I got Mr. Bill on the operating table here. Did the clay guy, the little clay guy, have a name? The little claymation guy that they ran over with a car and squeezed him in the door sill and all that? Did he have a name? Or is that Mr. Bill? Let's get on with it. Boy, if it looks like a face now. I'm gonna take one of my rockets and send this up to Mars. When they see this, oh boy. Mr. Bill on Mars. Energize. Right on, right on, right on. I definitely do not want to run my drill into the parallel. The parallel is hardened steel. It will destroy the drill bit in a nanosecond. One. That's one. Now Mr. Bill is winking. Oh! I'm having so much fun. Bink, 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 bink. That looks good. I love working with brass. All its own little weird noises. Alright, Mr. Bill is done. Alright, so I'm cleaning this, the old denatured alcohol again. Cleaning this real good because I'm going to put the pivot pin in permanently, well, semi-permanently with some removable medium strength thread locker called Pro Seal, and I did not open it when I bought it a while back because this stuff tends to dry up. It's ridiculous expensive for all it is glue, some kind of special glue. And see, it's like all over the jar, all over the cap. Where did that come from? I haven't even taken it out of the package. It's already leaking. A little test fit here. Alright, that's good. So just a pinch between your cheek and gum. I'm going to do both because I want it to soak into the threads. So everything is coated properly. I'm going to snug it up. That's pretty darn snug. Again, I'm going to take the excess off. I'll set this aside to dry.